Welcome to this order of worship for evening in celebration of the 100th anniversary of the 19th Amendment and women's right to vote. This service also celebrates St. David's women throughout the centuries. This service begins in Old St. David's, where parishioner and suffragist Catherine Wentworth Rushenberger would have worshiped. This service will include prayers, readings from scripture and history, and music from our children's primary and youth choir, our adult choir, and our bell choirs. Our service will end in St. David's Chapel to represent how we have come so far and how we continue to move forward in the light of Christ. Light and peace to you in Jesus Christ our Lord. Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to them,
"Is a lamp brought in to be put under the bushel basket or under the bed and not on the lampstand?
For there is nothing hidden except to be disclosed, nor is anything secret except to come to light. Let anyone with ears to hear listen." And he said to them,
"Pay attention to what you hear. The measure you will give will be the measure that you get, and still more will be given you.
For to those who have, more will be given, and from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away."
He also said,
"The kingdom of God is as if someone would scatter seed on the ground, and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow. He does not know how.
The earth produces of itself, first the stalk, then the head, then the full grain in the head.
But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with his sickle,
because the harvest has come."
Let us pray. Grant us, Lord, the lamp of charity which never fails, that it may burn in us and shed its light on those around us, and that by its brightness we may have a vision of that holy city where dwells the true and never failing light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God all my life long. Do not put your trust in princes, in mortals, in whom there is no help. When their breath departs, they return to the earth. On that very day, their plans perish.
Happy are those whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God, who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, who keeps faith forever, who executes justice for the oppressed, who gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the strangers. He upholds the orphan and the widow. But the day of the wicked he brings to ruin. The Lord will reign forever. Your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord.
Wisdom, chapter 7, verses 24 to 28. For wisdom is more mobile than any motion. Because of her pureness, she pervades and penetrates all things. For she is a breath of the power of God and a pure emanation of the glory of the Almighty. For she is a reflection of eternal light, a spotless mirror of the working of God, and an image of his goodness. Although she is but one, she can do all things, and while remaining in herself, she renews all things. In every generation, she passes into holy souls and makes them friends of God and prophets. For God loves nothing so much as the person who lives with wisdom.
Many women and men worked for the cause of suffrage and women's rights, both here in Pennsylvania, around the country, and around the world. St. David's Episcopal Church is proud to call an important suffragette, Catherine Wentworth Ruschenberger, one of our own. An active member of the Pennsylvania Women's Suffrage Association, Catherine commissioned, at her own expense, the Justice Bell, a bronze replica of the Liberty Bell with which she toured the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania in support of the proposed amendment to the Pennsylvania State Constitution called Amendment 1, extending voting rights to women. The Justice Bell is also known as the Women's Liberty Bell or the Suffrage Bell. This bell, which is now displayed at Valley Forge Historical Park Chapel, had two differences from the original Liberty Bell. To the inscription, "Proclaim liberty throughout all the land unto all the inhabitants thereof," Catherine added, "Establish justice and secure the blessings of liberty." In addition, the bell's clapper was chained to the side of the bell to show that women's political voices were silenced. The bell was greeted around Pennsylvania with parades, bands, and chants of "Father, brother, husband, son, vote for amendment number 1. The referendum lost by a narrow margin in Pennsylvania, but Catherine did not lose hope. The bell toured the nation in support of the 19th Amendment, which was ratified August 26, 1920, finally guaranteeing the vote to American women. We celebrate this momentous occasion even as we acknowledge and mourn that this fundamental American right was not accessed evenly by all women. Due to racism, anti-immigration laws, and the lack of citizenship extended to Native peoples. We give thanks for Catherine's work and celebrate her legacy that extends to all of us to this day. A month after women's political equality was ratified by two-thirds of the states, the Justice Bell rang out in Independence Square in celebration at the hands of Catherine Wentworth, Catherine's 17-year-old niece, to represent the next generation of women voters. Catherine died in 1943, and she and her husband, Charles Wister Ruschenberger, are buried in the St. David's Churchyard.
Thank you. today, and I will be reading a reading from history. The journey of women's voting rights is a complicated journey with many well-known and unknown people working across generations to bring about women's equality. At many points, white leaders in the suffrage movement ignored or undermined African American and other women of color. Thus, even as we celebrate the 19th Amendment that extended voting rights to women, we mourn how the Black community did not fully have voting rights until the Voting Rights Act of 1965. Let us remember one of the early Black suffragists and thank God for her example and perseverance in the face of multiple oppressions and challenges. Sojourner Truth was born into slavery in New York State, and after slavery was abolished in the state, Sojourner moved to New York City as a free woman. She was active in the African Methodist Episcopal Church and was known to preach and pray and sing with remarkable passion and eloquence. She also worked at a shelter for homeless women, convinced that showing Christ's love required meeting the material needs of the poor and vulnerable. At approximately 46 years old, Sojourner heard a call from God telling her to go east and preach the gospel, telling the truth of her experiences as a slave and the Christian imperative to support the abolition of slavery. After over a year of traveling and preaching, she joined an abolitionist or anti-slavery cooperative in Northampton, Massachusetts, which had been founded on principles of women's rights and pacifism in addition to its abolitionist mission. Sojourner became a traveling preacher, approaching white religious meetings and campgrounds and asking to speak. Captivated by her charismatic presence, her wit, and her wisdom, they found her hard to refuse. She never learned to read or write, but quoted extensive Bible passages from memory in her sermons. Her reputation grew, and she became part of the abolitionist and women's rights speakers network. Until her death, she continued to speak and preach, advocating for the right to vote to be expanded to all women, not only white women. The following is a recitation of the speech she is best known for, which is normally called Aren't I a Woman? The speech was given at a women's rights convention in Akron, Ohio, in 1851. This transcription was published by the Reverend Marius Robinson on June 21st, 1851, in the Salem Anti-Slavery Bugle, a few weeks after the speech was given. The version that is most common was constructed and published nearly 12 years later and appears to have been radically altered from her actual words. Thank you.
So this speech was given by Sojourner Truth in 1851, and I just wanted to add that it wasn't until 1965 that Black women received the right to vote in America. May I say a few words? I want to say a few words about this matter. I am a woman's rights. I have as much muscle as any man, and can do as much work as any man. I have plowed and reaped and husked and chopped and mowed, and can any man do more than that? I have heard much about the sexes being equal. I can carry as much as any man and can eat as much too, if I can get it. I am as strong as any man that is now. As for intellect, all I can say is, if women have a pint and man a quart, why can't she have her little pint full? You need not be afraid to give us our rights for fear we will take too much, for we can't take more than our pint will hold. The poor men seem to be all in confusion and don't know what to do. Why, children, if you have women's rights, Give it to her, and you will feel better. You will have your own rights, and they won't be so much trouble. I can't read, but I can hear. I can hear the Bible and have learned that Eve called man to sin. Well, if women upset the world, do give her a chance to set it right side up again. The lady has spoken about Jesus, how he never spurned woman from him, and she was right. When Lazarus died, Mary and Martha came to him with faith and love and besought him to raise their brother. And Jesus wept, and Lazarus came forth. And how come came Jesus into the world? Through God who created him and woman who bore him. Man, where is your part? But the women are coming up, blessed be God, and a few of the men are coming up with them. But man is in a right place. The poor slave is on him. Woman is coming on him, and he is surely between a hawk and a buzzard.
A prayer in honor of Sojourner Truth, Liberator and Prophetic Witness, 1883. Almighty God, who has made the church to be one body with many members and many gifts, we thank you for the witness of your daughter, Sojourner Truth, and for her courage to preach the truth of your liberating love in the face of great injustice. Grant that we, like her, may use our time, talents, and energy to proclaim the coming of your kingdom, which is good news to the poor, and in which all the oppressed shall be made free, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
We pray for remembrance and celebration of the women who have come before us, the named women of the suffrage movement, most especially our St. David's forebear, Catherine Wentworth Rauschenberger. Light of Christ, be among us. We remember and celebrate other notable St. David's women who served the common good through their work, service, and ministry, including Mary Polly Wayne, Lady Patriot, Beatrice Edgerly McPherson, artist and teacher, Dorothy Harrison Eustace, founder of the Seeing Eye organization to train guide dogs for the blind, Rose Bampton Pelletier, celebrated American opera singer, Virginia Pleasance, harpsichord player. We remember and celebrate the Reverend Susan Cox Kepi, the first woman priest to serve at St. David's. Light of Christ, be among us. We remember and celebrate all those women and men who have worked for generations to establish justice and secure the blessings of liberty. Light of Christ, be among us. We remember and ponder with heavy hearts how we have not always looked out for those who are bowed down by oppression, for prisoners, strangers, the orphan and the widow, for exclusion that pushed Black, Latina, Indigenous, and Asian women to the back. Light of Christ, be among us. We remember and celebrate women of color who worked for women's rights, including Sojourner Truth, Harriet Ross Tubman, Mary Church Terrell, Maria Stewart, Frances Ellen Watkins Harper, Daisy Lampkin, Sisters Harriet Fortin Purvis and Margareta Fortin, Ida B. Wells Barnett, Alice Dunbar Nelson, Jovita Idar, Zitkala Sa, Mary Louise Botineau Baldwin, Mabel Ping Hua Lee. Light of Christ, be among us. May we follow in the footsteps of those like Elizabeth Cady Stanton, whose example prompts us to be brave and bold and true in the honest convictions of our souls. May we partner together for the freedom, justice, and equality for all of God's children, working to show the light of Christ in all the world. Light of Christ, be among us. O God, whose Spirit guides us into all truth and makes us free, strengthen and sustain us as you did your servants, like Elizabeth Cady Stanton, Sojourner Truth, and Catherine Wentworth Rauschenberger. Give us vision and courage to stand against oppression and injustice and all the works against the glorious liberty to which you call all your children. Through Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Almighty, everlasting God, let our prayer in your sight be as incense, the lifting up of our hands as the evening sacrifice. Give us grace to behold you, present in your word and sacraments, and to recognize you in the lives of those around us. Stir up in us the flame of that love which burned in the heart of your Son as he bore his passion, and let it burn in us to eternal life and to the ages of ages. Amen. The wisdom of God, the love of God, and the grace of God strengthen you to be Christ's hands and heart in this world. In the name of the Holy Trinity. Amen.